Hi everyone, and welcome to Open Source Tonight. Hi everyone, and welcome to Open Source Tonight. Today what I wanted to talk to you about is the fact that OBS Studio can record ProRes and DNx HD if you want. So let's go ahead and go check it out. In my case, we're going to be demoing ProRes. All right, so I'm going to go open OBS. As you can see here, it's already open. And I'm going to hit record, or not record, I'm going to hit settings. It's already recording. I'm going to go to output, recording up here. Oh, I almost forgot. You need to change this output mode to advanced up here. I can't change it because I'm actually using this to record. We hit record. And then you can see here I have a directory called screen recordings. We can look at that. If you come look at that, we can actually see that right now we've actually got the screen recording we're recording right now. Okay? And we can see here I've got my audio encoder set down here to signed integer 24-bit. All right. And a little Indian. And then I've got my video bitrate here. I don't actually think it uses this, so I just leave it off, but it might actually. I'm not 100% sure. Kind of just been playing around with this the last few days, so I gotta say I'm not fully sure if I know how I'm doing this yet, but figured I'd share it with you anyway. So for your video encoder, you're gonna scroll around until you find ProRes AW or ProRes KS with the underscore between them. Personally, for me, I'm using the AW, but you know, you could probably use the KS as well. I don't really think that would be a problem. But anyway, I'm using AW, and I've actually been playing with the command line as well, and so that's why I've been using it here, and it seems to work for me. So once we got all that done, we're good to go as far as I can tell. I can just hit OK, and now I can, of course, start recording. But of course, we're already doing that, so I'd stop the recording. But anyway, it's pretty much that easy, and then you can open it up in anything that supports ProRes. In my case, I'm opening it up in DaVinci Resolve. It gives me very, very good screen recording quality that I can then use for these videos. Well, everybody, thanks for watching Open Source Tonight. Hope you found today's information useful and informative. And until next time, goodbye, everybody. And action.